अभ्यानपिण ध्यानंजनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितंगेना तस्मै श्रीगुरवे वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो नमो महावदन्ताय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदाय कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्य नाम्ने गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै तदाय कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तदभक्ताय यस्टर्डे आई एक्सप्लेन About the goal of life. Krishna is not goal of our life. He is manli sambandh, relation. We should have a relation with Krishna. To serve Krishna is avidheya. What is this? Avidheya?
Process.
But actually our goal is Krishna Prem. Krishna Prem. Prem, my seva, service to Krishna. Krishna is Supreme Lord. Very beautiful. Very beautiful. More than thousands of moons of There is no word in universe to speak or to give any
proper description.
He is so much qualified, merciful, unlimited. For all qualities are Even so many qualities who are some opposites, all are in Krishna. You know that Krishna is Lord of Lords, Ramchandra, Narayana and all other Lords. They have 60 qualities in full. These qualities are full in Bhagavat Tattva. But more full qualities, Rupa Madhuri. Rupa Madhuri means? Rupa Madhuri, Leela Madhuri, sweet past tense. Any of the manifestation of Krishna, even Ramchandra, Narayana, Nrisimha, or they cannot play roles with so many gopis. They cannot. Even Dwarkadhish Krishna, he cannot do. He cannot do. Like Krishna. So, Rupa Madhuri, Leela Madhuri, Vem Madhuri, all can fight with one. And Krishna, oh, He will take anyone's heart by throat. Very sweet. And Parikar Madhuri. His all associates are so sweet. So, Krishna is supreme. So he is praying toward the prema of anyone towards Krishna is prayojan. We see Arjun. He has so much love and affection that Krishna accepted his service to serve Arjun. All are serving Krishna, Ram, Nisinga. But Krishna is so sweet that he wants to serve his devotees. And he has promised Ananyas Chintayanto Man Je Janam Padjupasati Teshamam Nitya Abhijuktanam Yoga Chemam Bahamyam. What is the meaning? Pundarik is here, or he will see the dogs. Why? You should explain.
In this verse in Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna is stating that those who are exclusively devoted to me, Ananyas Chintayanto Mam, that for them, whatever they are lacking, I provide. And whatever they already have, then I maintain that.
Not good explanation. Something like Ananyas Chintayanto. They are only engaged. They have engaged their whole senses. More like Uttama Bhakti. And they don't think about his mentality, their mentality, nothing. They are none other than Krishna. Only serving Krishna, Vishnu. And not anything to maintain his body. They have no time at all to think all these things. No desire at all, except to serve Krishna. And if they have no time to maintain themselves, then I go there to them and see what they need, how to maintain them. I anyhow discover and then, I maintain themselves. Carrying the things, objects on my head, carrying on my shoulders. And personally, not by anyone other. So here Arjun has no time to look after him, look after his wife and children. You know, Krishna, what is? He is training the archery to Abhimanyu Dishan of Arjun. What is he doing? His chariot. And Arjun gets order. And he follows the order. Arjun told, that you should take my chariot in the midst of the boat. What Arjun is telling? Even horses are now tired. And then what did? It gave water to, and he was messaging horses, not Arjun, what to tell Arjun, he was messaging his horses and made fresh. So even if there was dog, Krishna can serve that dog of Arjun, if you know. You know, he could not repay Arjun. Hanuman was serving. And Ram was pleased, but not so much pleased. He was not controlled. And by Arjun, he was so much pleased. He became charioteer. He washed his horses, made them fresh. Also, he went to Shankar Mahadev, told that he will have to help Arjun because he will have to fight a big war and he should own the race. So you should give all archery, all qualities, all astra shastra, weapons to I did order to Hanuman. Oh, you should always be with me on the chariots. And he was there. And he told not only to be, sometimes in dangerous times you should help Arjun and say. So he said so many times in Mahabharata. Also, he discovered a chariot and horses for and gave to Arjun. By whom? Through fire. You know?
Yeah.
Agni Dev. And he told that, your band Tarkas in fish. Will not be empty any time. Never, never. You will take and it will fall. For Karna and Dosatam and others, Bhishma Pitama, so many cords. And you know that with the arrow of Bhishma Pitama, Arjun chariot was finished. Horses both. But Krishna made them alive. And when war was finished, no need of chariot, Krishna told that, now you should get down. And then Arjun. Then Arjun told him, why? Or you will be finished. Very quickly you should get down. He said, why you are telling so? Oh, I'm sorry. No, follow my order now. And he came down from the chariot. And after that, Krishna came down. And what began? In a second, it was finished in a fire. Automatically. Why it became? It was finished. But in the first arrow of Bhishma Pitama. But I kept your horses and everything. I kept Hanuman only. He always saved you. So what he did for Arjun? He gave him one sister married to Krishna, Arjun. You know? Taking milk in one same day, sleeping on same power. But Krishna is not controlled. He showed his universal form and he began, Prabhu, I have done mistake. Our offenses. I will never tell you, Prabhu, Shakha. I have told all this very bad thing. So I have made so many offenses. And you remember the image? He supported that. Always praying. But, you know, before that, when Krishna came to Mathura, and he told to Uddhava, what Uddhava? Uddhava gacha brajamushamna pitrino pritimava. Uddhava, You should go to prison. My father and mother are living in the Kali. They have become blind. One is skeleton. Oh, their life is for one day, two days. They can die at once, at any time, any moment. Please go and pacify. And then he told, oh, Gopinan, what Bayogi, Biyoga, Avadhi, Matsang Daishai, Bhimomacha. Oh, also go to Gopis. My father and mother are like so that I told you. They are bathing bitterly, they are blind. They may die. But I don't know Gopis. That how separation, oh, top separation, they are feeling. I don't know whether they are right or they are not. Go at once quickly. They are feeling separation topmost form. So, you should go. Tamanmanashta. Always what doing? Remember. For what? For their own purpose? No. Oh, they know that in Mathura there is none to know the heart of Krishna. Krishna is very shy. He cannot ask
for meat to anyone.
Bread and butter for anyone. Who will eat? Oh, then no. Jasoda Maitya, not even Rohini. So to whom? And who will pacify you? Krishna. Who will serve Krishna? So they want. They are feeling separation so much. Mat prana, they are my life and soul. They are not for, told for his father, not here. Mother, they have left everything. For body, what we want? Oh, they have left everything. Daya comments. तुम नीचे यहाँ पर आकर के बैठता क्यों नहीं यहाँ पर जगह है तो तू घर में बैठता है चोर जैसा दैह का पार्ट मीनिंग दैह का यस दे डोंट केयर फॉर देयर बॉडी दे आर फॉरगेटन ऑल थिंग्स माम ये बोले एंड मल्ली देयर पिरामिड Malli Malli. They are my most beloved. Prestham Atmanam. Oh, even my soul, life there. Jetaita Lok Dharmanscha Madathetan Vibhagnam. That left their shyness. They left their Lokdharma. Lokdharma means?
Worldly.
Responsibility. And not only this. What they will tell. They have left all these things. Why? For me, yeah. They disobey their parents. Why? For me. They have left their maintenance. Why? For me. So I must anyhow set them, maintain them. Dharayanti ati Krishna. They are now forfeit. And anyhow, that Krishna will come tomorrow. If he will die, then Krishna may die. So they are not dying. Anyhow, they are maintaining their lives. Only their life is life उनका बचा हुआ है केवल ये मैं कल आऊंगा इस पर. Because Krishna has promised, he cannot break his promise. He must come. So tomorrow he will come. Tomorrow he will come. And that is why they have kept their life. Anyhow, I think that they have not kept their life, my son, because their life in me. So I am maintaining. Otherwise, they will have been finished. Go at once and see whether they are died or not. If not dead, then pacify them. And Uddhava, he has not told anything like this to anyone. To Pandava, to Arjun, to the twin of Saptabhama, Rukmini. Why? Because they are boundless, causeless love and affection for Krishna. And that is the object. That is most high. The love of Krishna, which was in gopis. Especially, you can know that all the gopis, like Lalita, Vishakha, Chitra, Champaklata, and all, Rukmini. They were serving at that time pacifying Radhika. Who can pacify? Who can? To whom pacify? See, Radhika was totally mad. No sense at all. So others were pacifying because they were incense. No? Lalita, Vishakha, all were incense. Their love is so high. More than millions of Uddhava. So hard. More than millions and more than Saptabhama Rukmini. More than even the Sakhis of Vrindavan. But in comparison of Radhika, not so hard. So Radhika was totally mad. And Uddhava saw. How he saw in Brahmargi, a bamboo bee. Oh, also this bamboo bee was Krishna. He went to Braj in the shape, in form of bamboo bee. And he saw Radhika totally mad and he was sleeping in a bed of rose flowers, petals. And it was joy. So much Chandan was given, cool, but even it was fried. Shiva dead or in life, or he could not imagine what he was. And she was sometimes very angry, more to Krishna, criticizing Krishna, abusing him. So, cheater, ungrateful. Even Saptabhama and all other cannot tell Krishna like this. Oh, Mother Yashoda and Baba even cannot tell like this. That gopis are dead, ungrateful. You are like bumblebees of 6 feet, more than animal. Animal, human form had 2 legs and animals 4 legs. And Bati, or like this, bumblebee, 6 legs. So they are more than any animal. Comparing him. Oh, so many things. We don't have don't want to have any relation with that black person, with black heart. Black, like Bumblebee. We know there was a Ram, also black. And who was he? What queen? He cheated Surpanakha and... So there are so many things. So, Srimad Bhagavat is the explanation of the love of Radhika, glorifying Radhika's love. So, the love in Radhika is topmost. Oh, this is the goal of whole what? Living beings. They cannot receive like this. Never. But a drop that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave to Rupa Goswami, endless ocean of nectar, of rasa, bhakti rasa. He gave one drop. And even one drop can sink whole universe. So, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave this. If we can serve these gopis, especially to Radhika, then we can have a love affection for Krishna, and then we can feel separation so much, otherwise never and never. So this is goal of all life. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Goswami has, and Srimad Bhagavat Sukadeva Goswami has, in final touching, conclusion, that our goal is what? Krishna Prem. But like whom? Oh my, like that. So, Krishna told to Uddhava, and now he knew that gopis have so much love and affection for Krishna. But he has no experience still, not. No? He heard that gopis are most beloved of Krishna. Krishna is most beloved of gopis. He knew this thing. But how their love is, how tall, and in what way, and what is that love? He had love for Krishna. Like, oh, he is my Prabhu, he is like my brother, he is like, oh, so many things. But not, Krishna is not telling anything for Uddhava like so. But he is telling to Uddhava, go. Why? Oh, you should go and realize what is praying to me. In Mathura, there is none like. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, out of his darshi, sprinkled a drop on Arpit Charinjira. And this is our goal of life. Uddhava went to Braja. Why I am telling all these things? Make it clear what is the goal. First make a goal. And then process. If there is no goal, what is process? Everywhere it has been gone. Nigama kalpa taroor galitam phalana sukha mukha adayam mrita darvasanam jyutam ivata bhagavata rasamalayam maho rasika bhurha. Oh, this is object of Srimad Bhagavata. Three slokas from beginning are explaining Srimad Bhagavatam. Especially 10th canto is explained only Nigama Kalpa Taroor Galitam. How Srimad Bhagavatam? Krishna is the ocean of rasa. So our object is all this love and affection for Krishna. Like gopis. Like to serve Radhika. Like this. Now Uddhava went to Braja. He has so much love and affection for Krishna. But a new thing, totally new thing for him. And when he kept his left in Braja, and he realized, what he saw? He saw Krishna is playing everywhere. All the sakhas are playing with Krishna. Oh, millions of cows hankering after Krishna. And so much of big horse. And milk is automatic. And cups so beautiful, charming, white, black. And they are jumping here and there. Bulls, oh, big, big bulls of Nanda Baba. What doing? Fighting each other. And gopis are what? In the morning, he saw that scene of morning. Of very beautiful lamps in gopis' roof of ghee. Not like this. Hey, that thing. And he, very well. Snigdha. And so much fragrance coming everywhere from flowers. Bumblebees, what doing?
Humming.
What? They were blowing the shankha of Kama. Everywhere birds were singing, cuckoo birds and peacocks. What doing? Kekaw and dancing everywhere. Sakhar were like this, and all the gopis churning and doing Gopinda.
Dumb stuff.
Oh, he could not imagine how high class of love and affection can be. Now we realize something of how high class of love and affection. But when he in the morning and he went to Kadamba Kiyani, where all the gopis met and about to die there. Anyhow, by the mercy of Krishna, he saw the gopis there. And he is there. And he saw and realized something. And for this thing, Krishna has sent Buddha to go to Vrindavan, try to be admitted in the school of gopis, where I was admitted. And then you should return back, and then we can speak something about love and affection. So go and be first qualified. But he was not qualified to be admitted in the school of, because his numbers were about 25%. And there they needed what? More than 85% numbers. So they rejected. But he went there in the school and saw how high class of students are there, and professor and principals were there, like Vishakha, like Lalita Vishakha, and principal herself, Raj. And then he saw, and then he prayed, Bande Nanda Brij Kistrinam Pad Renum Abhikshna Sarit Jasam Harit Katho Gita Punati Hon. And now he knew the glories of gopis, how they love Krishna. He had never seen like this. And now he felt that if I want to love Krishna, then I must be admitted in this school, but I am not qualified. He requested gopis that if you are not admitting in your school, can you please take me like a servant to give water, like a servant to clean the school, college? Oh, that is rejected also. He was not here. No. You should go and return back, then be qualified, and then you can broom here. Even you cannot broom. You cannot broom our punya. Can we do? Not. So, he was praying now. Bande Nanda Braja Istrinam. Who are Nanda Braja Istrinam? All the gopis, beloved of all gopis of Krishna. Oh, I want to pray, offer myself. I want to pray, I want to keep one even particle of your dust, food dust. If one particle, can you tell that particle of what, which a special gopi, then it must be of Srimati Radhika. Brahma cannot attend this. Shankar cannot. Even Saptabhama and all others cannot. So Krishna has sent him to see the glory of the gopi. Then he will tell, same glory. He saw the Himalaya, the peak, highest peak, Everest. And he saw like this. He cannot become, could not become like that. He had to return back to Krishna, empty hand. Only that Sandesh was there. What Sandesh? Message that, oh, I went there. What I saw, very strange, very wonderful. I cannot explain all this. You told, it is told through more than you told. But I could not realize anything. So I had to return back. Vande Nanda Vraja Istrinam Padrenum Apikshnasa Jasam Harikatho Udgita. What they have told, that Brahma Gita. In Gopigi, Jayakiti Dhikam. In this Tava Kathamritam Taptaji. In this thing. And it will purify whole universe. Whole universe. If anyone recite, even they will remember this thing. What will be? Really, all they will purify. So you should try to recite all these things. You should try to know all these things. Meaning are very deep, very deep. Swamiji, your Gurudev, Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami. Wonderful book, this, of very wonderful things. This object, but I today, yesterday I told, why he should plant this in barren land or no desert? Oh, he should make that land fertile, cultivate, and bury it. They want it, but in the meantime, oh Prabhu, Radhika called him. Oh, come at once, we need your service. So this is our goal. Asha maho, charna reni juham. Rasa maho, charna reni juham ham syam. Vrindavane kimap gulm lasau. Yadvastvajan hadvajan ardhapathan chahitva bheje mukunda padavim. If not of Radhika, lotus feet dust particle. Even anyone in Vrindavan, Braj Gopis, and I will be satisfied. I don't want the dust of Krishna lotus feet. If I want to please Krishna, then I will have to take a part of your goods. So I want your mercy, causeless mercy. This is the object. And then we will come down the process told by Srila Rupa Goswami and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur, Narayana Thakur. Same thing in new quotas. But why is it same? If you take that money, you must be mad. What is the... No harm. The color of bottles are different. No. But wine is there. So, we will explain. The process from beginning, Adav Shaddha, Nansap, Adu Sadhu Sangha, then Shraddha, Anartham Nivitti, Ruchi, then Asakti, and Rati Bhav. And after that, no sadhana. No sadhana. Only the mercy of Gopis is there. Go, Prama. Today is perhaps drama also. You should do everything. They should announce
Hare Krishna.
You should make a place for drama.
Hare Krishna. Some devotee has requested for initiation. So initiation is tomorrow 8:30 a.m. So who have registered their name is Jagmohan Prabhu. I am requesting you all who have registered their name is Jagmohan Prabhu, they will come to Gurudev's Bhajan Kuti 242, room number 242, 8 a.m. Who has not registered their name yet for initiation, Please register your name tonight in Jagmohan Prabhu. Hare Krishna. Only who will take initiation, they will come because room is too small. So we cannot receive all devotees there. Only who will take initiation, they will come there.
Hare Krishna. Whoever has found Sambhu, Gauriya Gita Bhakti, please bring it to Jagmohan Prabhu or myself. Devotees here. By showing the power of association with exalted devotees. One day, Maharaj Yudhisthira asked Narada Muni some questions.
Oh, my dear Narada, you've been very kind to explain the proper behavior for brahmachari, vanaprastha, and sannyas. But I have a question. Would you kindly tell how someone in the household order of life can live properly according to the Vedic injunctions?
My dear King Yudhisthira, those who stay home as householders must act to earn their livelihood. But instead of trying to enjoy the results of those actions themselves, they should offer those results to Krishna. How to satisfy Krishna in this life can be fully understood by association with the exalted devotees of the Lord. A Grihastha must associate again and again with saintly persons in order to fully understand the position of a Grihastha. The first duty of a Grihastha is to be fully dependent upon Krishna and to try to satisfy him with devotional service. This devotional service depends upon the instructions of the spiritual master. The beginning of devotional service is called Shraddha, or hearing. One must hear from the mouth of pure devotees. In this way, the attraction to his wife and children will gradually be reduced. As for the maintenance of his family, a Grihastha, while earning what is required for a living, should not be overly eager to earn more money than necessary simply for sense gratification. A Grihastha must always remember that one who is attempting to accumulate more wealth than necessary should be considered a thief and is punishable by the laws of nature. A Grihastha must treat all animals like his own children, and whatever he may possess, he should distribute equally to all living entities. The best process for this is to distribute prasadam. A Grihastha should not be overly attached to his wife, but he should engage her in service to Krishna with all attention and to guests that come to the home. A Grihastha should only eat prasadam, and he should travel to all the places of pilgrimages mentioned in the Puranas. In this way, a Grihastha should be fully engaged in worshipping the Supreme Lord, Shri Krishna. My dear King Yudhisthira, a person who has surrendered to the Supreme Lord, the ocean of nescience becomes like the water in the hoofprint of a cow. I will give you some examples of this from my own life.
I existed as the Gandharva known as Upavahana, I was very respected by the other Gandharvas. I had a beautiful face and a pleasing, attractive bodily structure. Decorated with flower garlands and sandalwood pulp, I was most pleasing to the women of our city. Thus, I was bewildered, always feeling lusty desires. Almost exalted Upavarna. There is a Sankirtan festival glorying the Supreme Lord coming this way, and all the Gandharvas and Apsaras are invited.
Yes, yes. I too shall join the parade and add my beautiful voice to the rejoicing. Come, ladies, let us sing.
Jaya Radhe, Jaya Krishna, Jaya Radhe. Therefore, must curse you. You would have become a Shudra at once and become devoid of all your beauty.
Oh no! How unfortunate I have become because of my sinful activities.
Therefore, because of my offense, I was born as the son of a maidservant. One day, my mother instructed me.
My dear son, today our lives have become so greatly fortunate because for the next 4 months, you will be serving some very exalted sages. I give you full responsibility to see to all the needs of these sages. I want you to tend to all the desires with deep devotion. If you can see these sages, you will still be much younger.
Yes, Mother. I'll do as you instruct and serve you to my best abilities.
Service. Therefore, you may join us in our discussions of the absolute truth and the goal of life.
Sajiva is by nature a servant of Krishna. Atmarati, or spiritual attachment to Krishna, is naturally present in your pure spiritual form. This attachment to Krishna is the goal of life. But one should not be complacent and think that bhakti will arise naturally of its own accord by some good fortune. Rather, one should endeavor greatly with eagerness to obtain aparati.
First, you must give up all desire for reward-seeking activity by association with devotees. Soon, by such association, Shraddha, or deep faith, will arise. Then you will become fit to assimilate Harikatha, and spiritual instruction. When such deep faith arises, you should take shelter of a Bhikshu Guru and receive the Sri Yugala Mantra. Having received this mantra, you should worship the Diksha and Siksha Guru with intense attachment, or Atmarati.
You should not be satisfied simply to offer respect to your Sri Gurudev. Oh, considering him to be a mere sage. Rather, you should serve him with love and devotion, as if, accepting him as if he was your dearest friend and well-wisher.
Once you cultivate true attachment to Harinam and the mantra given by your Diksha Guru, considering Sri Sri Radha Krishna Yugala to be your very life and soul, you should take shelter at their lotus feet. In this way, you can obtain prema bhakti.
Now it is time to rest. We will continue your instructions tomorrow.
Thus, during two seasons, the rainy season and autumn, I had the opportunity to hear these great devotees constantly chant the unadulterated glories of Lord Hari. As the flow of my devotional service began, the covering of the modes of passion and ignorance vanished. I was very much attached to those sages. I was gentle in behavior, and all my sins were eradicated in their service. In my heart, I had strong faith in them. I had subjugated the senses, and I was strictly following them with body and mind. Their travels, but I remained because my mother was dependent on me as her only son. But one day, as she went to milk the cow early in the morning, a snake bit her and she died. I took this to be the special mercy of the Lord, who was always desiring benediction for his devotees. So thinking, I started for the north.
Or even demigods. Now I am tired, and
Oh, Krishna. Krishna. I see you. Krishna. Where have you gone? I cannot see you. Why have you left me? I must see you again. Krishna. Hare Krishna.
My dear Narada, I regret that during this lifetime you will not see me again. Those who are incomplete in service and who are not completely free from all material taint can hardly see me. O virtuous one, you have only seen my person once, and this is just to increase your desire for me. Because the more you hanker for me, the more you will be free from all material desires.
Oh, good. Lord Brahma.
the mother of Nara. Also, Narayan. Narayan, Sriman Narayan. And Upabarahan Prabhu. Upabarahan. All nouns, like. Anyhow, I went to, I remember so many drama plays, the flight in Bejar and in our Parikrama, like Prahlad Charitra, so beautiful. He became Nrisimhadeva. So like, it had, having so much teachings.